It's Tuesday, 7th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. DMK President M. Karunanidhi suffered a health setback on Monday, and doctors treating him at Cauvery Hospital set a 24-hour time frame to determine the prognosis. A large number of DMK cadres and supporters gathered outside the hospital soon after it issued a medical bulletin at 6:30 p.m. announcing that there was a decline in his medical condition. Union Minister Nitin Gadkari, accompanied by Tamil Nadu BJP President Tamilisai Soundarajan, arrived at the hospital to visit Mr. Karunanidhi. Hours after a few Supreme Court judges approached Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra, to express their anguish over the downgrade of Justice K.M. Joseph, Attorney General of India K.K. Venugopal met the CJI to clarify the seniority issue. Official sources suggested that the government may have gone by a transparent principle, backed by precedent, that gives primacy to All India seniority of High Court judges. According to this, Justice Indira Banerjee and Justice Vineet Saran, the two other judges cleared for elevation, are placed at 4th and 5th positions in the All India seniority of High Court judges respectively, while Justice K.M. Joseph is at the 39th position. In terms of precedence, the High Court Chief Justice seniority is irrelevant, said a government source. The government has gone by the time-tested precedent of recognizing the All India seniority of High Court judges while considering the elevation to the Supreme Court. In this context, the source recalled how Justice Deepak Mishra and Justice now retired J. Chelameswar were both elevated to the Supreme Court the same day during the UPA regime, but it was Justice Mishra who got seniority over Justice Chelameswar owing to his All India seniority of High Court judges. Hopeful of using its Commonwealth membership to pursue the extradition of Mehul Choksi from Antigua, the government has issued a gazette notification extending extradition rights to the Caribbean country as part of the Commonwealth procedure. Mr. Choksi, a jeweler and uncle of fugitive Nirav Modi, both of whom are wanted for loan defaults in India, has reportedly been residing in the islands of Antigua and Barbuda. He was granted a citizenship by investment there in November 2017. According to the Gazette notification made public yesterday, the government directed that the provisions of the Extradition Act 1962 shall apply with respect to Antigua and Barbuda. India has no extradition treaty with Antigua, but has discussed with officials in Antigua the possibility of using a clause in the Extradition Act 1993 that extends similar procedures to all 53 countries of the Commonwealth that former colonies of the United Kingdom are part of. These notifications constitute an extradition arrangement between India and Antigua and Barbuda under their Extradition Act of 1993 and provide the legal basis for extraditing offenders from each other's jurisdiction, government sources said on Monday. They also stressed that the countries only have an arrangement but not an extradition treaty. Indra Nooyi will step down as the CEO of PepsiCo after 12 years in the position, the company announced on Monday. Taking over the reins of the global giant in 2006, Ms. Nooyi steered the company through the 2008 financial crisis and remained in the spotlight as one of the most powerful women on the planet. Growing up in India, I never imagined I'd have the opportunity to lead such an extraordinary company, she said in a statement. Leading PepsiCo has truly been the honor of my lifetime, and I'm incredibly proud of all that we have done over the past 12 years to advance the interests not only of shareholders but all our stakeholders in the communities we serve. She has delivered strong and consistent financial performance, managing with an eye not only toward the short run but the long run as well. As CEO, she grew revenue more than 80%, outperforming our peers and adding a new billion-dollar brand almost every other year. And shareholders have benefited. $1,000 invested in PepsiCo in 2006 is worth more than 2.5 times that amount today, said Ian Cook, presiding director of PepsiCo's board of directors. The 54-year-old Ramon LaGuardia will succeed Ms. Nuyi as CEO. Ms. Nuyi will step down as CEO on October 3rd, but will remain chairman until early 2019 to ensure a smooth and seamless transition, the company said. The number of good days have gone up in Delhi and the bad days have declined, Union Minister Harsh Vardhan said on Monday while referring to the pollution levels in the national capital. Replying to queries in the Rajya Sabha, he said, "As far as pollution in Delhi is concerned, over the last 2 years continuously, the number of good days for Delhi have improved and the number of bad days have decreased." Quoting findings from an ICMR study, he said, "In the last 20 years from 1990 to 2016, there has been a reduction of 23.4% in illnesses caused due to pollution." Asked whether the government has carried out a study to assess the number of advisories issued by foreign countries against travel to India due to pollution and their impact on tourism, he said an environmental health profile study was being conducted in 20 cities. "We have a very ambitious program which involves multiple stakeholders, and in the last 2 years itself, we have increased forest cover in the country by about 7,000 square kilometers, and multiple ministries are involved in handling this issue," said the minister. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.01 rupees per litre and diesel for 68.48 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.32 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 79.92 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.26 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 84.45 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.70 rupees per litre.